What's up, YouTube? I am back today with Matt's Mystery Box Monday. This is a series I'm going to start probably on Mondays if it aligns. It won't be every Monday, but any Monday that I have a subscription box coming or close to it, I will be, you know, coming live with a Mystery Box video. Today we have the standard version of the Big Bat Box for November. This is the first time I have ever received this product myself, and the first time I've ever shown it on the channel. So I've seen it on lots of other YouTubers, and it looks like a pretty good value and a pretty cool product. I love the design of the box. You can buy this online at thebigbatbox.com. They have a couple different versions, and I don't believe there's a limit to how many you can order. Specifically, I ordered the Braves as a team. So there should be either a hit or a team pack with a handful of Braves cards. And when you order it, you can specify what team you want and go from there. So without wasting any more time discussing the product, I'm gonna go ahead and get this one open. So inside the box, we've got our raffle ticket. We have a little bit of information about the product. We have our packs and we have some packing peanuts. We'll go ahead and take those out. We also have a top loader, so pretty cool. And then in terms of what we can get, we have two retail packs from 2020 Allen and Ginter and 2019 Donruss. We have all four of the following. So there is a 06-07 Top Series 1 or 2. We have a 2019 Topps Hobby. We have a 2020 Opening Day, which I'm not super excited about that one. We've got a 19 or 20 Topps Archives, which is pretty cool. We have one factory sealed vintage pack and one favorite team hit, which would be a Braves hit. Raffle ticket is for a PSA authentic Hank Aaron signed baseball bat. I think that's the grand prize. So there's the rest of the information here, and we'll see what we get. So we've got a couple sleeves and a top loader for any, you know, hits in this package. Here's our bonus pack, which is a 2010 Baseball Series 2 Hobby. We have a 2020 Allen and Ginter. This is, looks to be retail. We have a 2019 Donruss pack. We have a 1987 Topps pack. Well, unfortunately, I just spoiled the hit. For me, anyway. I might edit that out. 2019 update. 2020 Archives Hobby. There's our 2020 Opening Day. 2006 Hobby Pack. And I'm gonna leave this one over here to the side. Unfortunately, I know who it is, and it's not a card I'm particularly excited about. But I'm gonna go ahead and open the Topps 2006 first. I have never opened one of these in my life. So this will be a first time of me seeing these cards. I'm not familiar with, off the top of my head anyway, what rookies were available in 2006 or what this set even looks like. So we'll see what we get. We've got a Rookie of the Year Houston Street card. We've got a Craig Biggio when he was still playing. We have a Freddy Garcia. I expect most of these players to be retired. We have a CC Sabathia, Royal Cormier. We have a Johnny. So first of all, we have an autograph in this pack, which is absolutely amazing. And this is a Johnny Podras autograph from the Los Angeles Dodgers. So based on this picture, you know, it looks like this man is playing for the Brooklyn Dodgers. Unfortunately, I have never heard of him. But we have an autograph from a really, really old player. This is really super cool. Go ahead and sleeve that up real quick. So on the back, Johnny cemented his name in Dodgers history when he pitched Brooklyn to its first World Series title in 1955. The series MVP beat the Yankees in Game 3 and shut them out in Game 7. All right, so unfortunately, I have never heard of him, but I feel like this is a fantastic autograph to have based on that quick description there. So there's our first hit, completely unexpected, and so far the bat box is delivering. Next up is Troy Gloss, Junior Spivey. We've got a McGee Wing and a random card. So the odds of that auto were 1 in 36. The hit odds are 1 in 36. So I don't know if that is for the auto or for a relic. Anyway, this is 2020 opening day, which I also have never opened. The opening day sets usually aren't spectacular based on my previous knowledge of collecting. We've got a Gregory Polanco, Victor Robles, gold cup card. We have a Clayton Kershaw, spring has sprung, you know, random insert here. But nothing crazy in that one. Next is 2020 Archives. So I'm doing these in no particular order, by the way. But next is 2020 Archives, which I have opened lots of, but nothing on video yet. Just I wanted to do those casually on my own time. We've got a Vladimir Guerrero Sr., Syndergaard. We have a Nolan Ryan 1954 card. Goose Gossage, same style. Same style Diaz rookie card with the Marlins. We have a Acuna All-Star rookie card. Jeff Bagwell, Willie Stargell, and that's it for that one. So some pretty cool cards. Lots of 1954 inserts in there, or versions of cards. Next up is 2019 Update, which I've also never opened. So again, I'm not super familiar with what cards are in majority of these packs. I'm just, you know, doing it for the hobby, and whatever I crack that's, you know, cool, that's just gravy, right? A Jimenez rookie card. Or rookie debut, I guess is what it's called. We've got a Kevin Biggio rookie debut. Richard rookie debut. Actually, that is a rookie card, not a debut. Andrew Miller with the Cardinals. Kelvin Herrera. We have a Alex Brigman 1984 Tops. Mardonal. Ronald Acuna Jr. All-Star Game card. That's a cool one to have. Alex Bregman. Beedy rookie card. Barraclough. And Jonathan Schoop. Pretty cool pack there. Next is 2019 Donruss. Fernando Romero. We have a Gleyber Torres. Tommy Milner. Apparently every other card in this set is upside down. You have a Yoan Moncada Diamond Kings card. We have a Javier Baez. Kyle Wright rookie card. That's a cool one to have. He played really, really well in the playoffs this year. And last was Joey Wendell. So we got the Kyle Wright rookie in that pack. It's probably the best card there. Next is Allen and Ginter retail. We have what looks to be a spacer in the back, so that's a bad sign. Eric Hosmer. We have a Ryu. Bogarts. We have a miniature anglerfish card. Benito Santiago. And Yelich. So the random card, I don't remember seeing that one in either of the two hobby boxes I opened. So the retail, like random, I don't know what to call them, but non-baseball baseball cards in the pack appear to be different in the retail versions. We have a Carlos, so this is 2010 Topps, by the way, Series 2. We have a Cargo, Torrey Hunter, Marlon Byrd. We have a Teixeira rookie card. This is not Mark Teixeira. Clay Buchholz. We have an Alex Gonzalez History of the World Series card. He played for the Braves for a little while. We have a Lou Gehrig. Carlos Quinton. Olivo. And last is a Felix Hernandez card with a code that has already been expired. I don't know what you get for that. I'm not sure what Topps Attacks is, but it's a code that can be redeemed for that, and I don't believe it's, I think it's more of a game and less of significant value. Last is Topps 1987 pack. I feel the gum in there. I haven't opened one of these in a very long time. As usual, there's a little bit of wax on the back card, and there's the gum. I will not be eating the gum. All right, so I flip these around. We've got a checklist. I'm going to blow through these relatively quickly. I'm not going to recognize majority of these players. Duncan. Sundberg. We have a 1987 Roger Clemens card. Tito Landrum. Glenn Wilson. Eddie Milner. Dave Smith. Lance Parrish. We have a Tony Gwynn All-Star card. He doesn't even look like the same guy in this picture, from what I remember in the late, you know, 90s. John Henry Johnson. Got a Jim Dwyer, Greg Matthews, Billy Bean, Greg Nettles, and that is the last card in the back. All right, now for the hit. The big hit in the box. So, if you have any guesses, this guy played for the Braves for a few years. He had a little bit of a ego and attitude problem, I suppose. I believe he went to Tampa Bay after. But this is a game used bat from 2010 Allen and Ginter of Yunel Escobar. So he was a shortstop for Atlanta. I think occasionally he might have played third base. But this is a miniature framed card with a kind of Hawaiian tropical style frame. This card is not numbered, and it's also not the greatest I've ever seen. You know, the center is moving around a lot. You can see the piece of the bat doesn't necessarily fit in that square. It's a little small. So not the best insert I've ever seen. But that was our big hit in the box. By far, the best card was this one. The cards were in absolutely fantastic shape. The packs were brand new. I didn't see any bits of damage on anything. So I definitely, you know, based on this box alone, I recommend the product. I think it was, you know, pretty good value. I remember it was either $43 or $53, including shipping. And we got to open some pretty cool packs, and I thought the value was pretty good, especially with the auto we scored, which was at least 1 out of 36. So my next few videos are going to include some older stuff. So I had bought some older 1997 boxes that I'm going to open on YouTube soon, and I want to get that content out to you guys. So it's going to be a little bit of a nostalgia trip and a little bit of a, you know, kind of search for the really, really big hits in those sets. Hopefully we hit them. You know, if not, it's just for good fun. So anyway, I'm going to end it today. Please like and subscribe this video and check out bigbatbox.com as well. And have a good day. Thanks, guys. Bye.